This is MS World, and I'm Dr. Daniel Kantor. We saw some interesting research that had to do with a medication called natalizumab, or Tysabri. Remember, that medication is given every 28 days, so every 4 weeks, basically once a month, IV, so into the vein, and it's used for relapsing multiple sclerosis. And the idea is to be a disease-modifying therapy. In this study, what the investigators looked at was they said, do people who get Tysabri, do they walk better? So although Tysabri is not the walking pill is called Ampira or dalfampridine, they said, do people who are on Tysabri walk better than if they hadn't been on Tysabri? And in fact, what they found is that people who were walking worse before being on Tysabri started walking better while on Tysabri. Some of the results weren't surprising. For example, if you were walking slower, you had more room for improvement than if you were already walking fast. Another interesting thing that was looked at was that the speed of walking didn't really correlate or connect to the amount of other disabilities that a person had. And so while a person's walking may have improved, it wasn't exactly the same person who the rest of the disabilities worked in. And that tells us something about what we're measuring in MS. One of the big issues in designing clinical studies for multiple sclerosis is choosing what our outcomes are. What are the things that we're trying to look at? Obviously, what we're trying to do is make you better. But we need to figure out a way of studying that in a concise, kind of prescribed way. And in this study, the walking and the disability didn't exactly go hand in hand. And that just gives us more food for thought about how we design future clinical studies. I think it's very important that people who are part of MS World and people all out there with MS get more involved in thinking about how MS clinical studies are designed. And actually, there's been a big push by the federal government in the United States to have patients more involved in the design of clinical trials, and we invite all of you to really be active participants and to make sure that you talk to your neurologist, talk to your other healthcare providers about what's important to you.